Hey, everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000, back with more Toad Strikes Back. In the last episode, we finished up Mount Vulcan, except for this one last thing, the Hall of Big and Small. Let's do it! I don't remember this level. Oh my gosh, it's humongous! It's the most large and in charge Goomba I think I've ever seen in my life. And, man, it's so big that, like, literally two squares of pipe takes up almost the entire- Look at those coins! Are they actually- They're actually worth 10 times as many points. That's hilarious. Oh my gosh, there's so many of them. There's so many coins. This reminds me- Oh, you know what this is like? This reminds me of Supermassive Galaxy in Mario Galaxy 2. This is like, it's like the same proportions. Like, everything is the- Well, actually, that world was even bigger than this, but still. It'd be funny if you got, like, a really giant hammer. Still, all your previous strategies continue to apply. Nothing has really changed. It's just... Excuse me. It's just the spectacle, you know? But spectacle's cool. Okay, so what about the small? Oh my gosh, look at this. Are we actually gonna... This is like... It's like fucking New Super Mario Bros. I'm a little disappointed. This is the same area! It's the same area, but it's small. It's like tiny, huge island. That's hilarious. I'm a little disappointed to not see any tiny enemies, because he could have just used the tiny Goomba sprite from Mario Bros. 3, you know, from All Stars, because he used the big Goomba sprite for the regular Goombas in this game, and then scaled it up again to make the giant ones in that level. He could have just used the regular sprite, but oh well. We're not gonna see regular sized enemies until we get to Psycho Waluigi. Well, I guess some enemies in this game are regular size, like those dry bones. And the Hammer Bros. It's really just like the Goombas, the Koopas, and the Shy Guys that are like giant. Okay, World 6. What an awkward start to the episode. I love this. They got like the disco ball from Bowser's Castle in Super Mario World as like lights. The music in this stage is awesome. To the lunar stage from Tetris Attack or Panel de Paul. You can squirt them down. Ain't this veggie the ugliest thing ever? But don't judge the book by its cover, for it makes a great umbrella. With all the crazy weather patterns around here, you ought to get one too. Because I'm watching Video Power right now too. Here's the mini game. Let's just start with a fresh mini game. What do we got? Vegetable. That's hilarious. Use the vegetables to keep the ball in the air. Don't let the ball touch the ground. Oh, this is gonna be a pain in the fucking ass, I bet. Da 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 do da 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 da. Wait, can I just like jump into it? I can. Okay. So it's basically just like it's just like Arkanoid, except I have to keep picking up a new paddle. It's like playing Arkanoid with one of those like Japanese paper fishing nets. I could also like throw it at him. I realize. Like I don't need to be catching him. It's just that gives me the most time. Okay. Hey, I actually got 3 lives. That's never happened before in this. I don't know what the hell I could have done there. Like, it was, like, the ball moved straight up and down on the far left, and the only vegetable appeared on the far right. You know what I would do there? I would have there be 2, sprouts at any given time. That's what I would do. 2 sprouts. Hello, lady. What's that door doing up there in the clouds, just suspended in midair like that? Yeah, she's pointing. If you hadn't found the, I probably should have talked to her before I did the minigame, because she hints that there's a door up there. Anyway, let's keep exploring the hub world before we do any levels. What do you say? A flying blue Yoshi? Oh, please. Everyone knows they don't really exist. I mean, come on. You can even see the strings holding that one up. And it is obviously wearing blue makeup. Well, I bet you're fun at parties. We got a big stalk here straight out of Sunflower Fields from Mario Land 4. Hello. So you are battling the Magic Koopa Kamek as well? My sisters and I have located one of the star seers in the castle, but... I love this. Like, this world has its own, like, trio of sky blue of I think they're called like the sky blue sisters or like the blue Yoshi sisters.
Oh man. If the blue Yoshi sisters couldn't stop that magic Koopa dude, then who can?
It's so weird that Dry Bones is freaking out about. Wait, are there only two of them? I thought there were three. Well, it's triangle attack, so surely there must be another one. Kamek even repelled our triangle attack. We're lucky we got out of it unharmed. If you are crazy enough to face him, then please be careful. I love that. Like, this world has its own group of super heroines. Oh, here's the other one. It seems the magic of Kamek has gained the ability to conjure up monsters from people's nightmares. Should you confront him, you must never lose your spirit. Anyway, that's a bit of foreshadowing there, and Mr. Angry Eyes is in the castle this time. You! If you want to annoy me so badly, come into the castle. I'm sure you'll enjoy all the traps and hazards, and all the baddies would just love to see you. Bingo! Anyway, let's get on with it. Let's get a move on. Shrooms in the snow. Not an awful lot to this map. Oh no, it's auto-scrolling. Okay, there's ninjis, and they don't die from jumping on them. Dang, dang. Oh man, what good commentary. I'm seriously? That's the best you can come up with? Making the noise that the stuff in the game makes? Shameful. Can I go on this pipe? Nope. Dwan, dwan. Okay, I think I actually want to stay down here to get a Oh no. What killed me? The pit or the wall? You decide. Okay, wait, didn't I have a fire flower? Well, I guess I'll never know now. Okay, let's try a different level, see if I can get a fire flower. For all I know, there was one earlier in that level, but... Oh, no! I remember this level. This level is actually the level... If you looked at the MFGG page for the game, this level is the level that the screenshot on the game's page is from. Ah, there we go. Dude, I wanted that mush! What the hell, man? Okay, get up there, please. I tell you what, this level is such a pain in the ass because the ice physics affect you even in the air. This reminds me of Ice Age Alley and Donkey Kong Country, the only ice cave level in the entire game, which is just so weird. Oh, you know what? I think this level is also really easy to get the secret in. I think the secret is just at the very end. Well, didn't I do that? Dude, would you get up there? Seriously. I think the secret in this stage is just right at the end, like literally at the gold switch, and all you need to do is do some fancy footwork with a fire flower to get it. But we'll find out, won't we? Oh, you know what I never did? No. I was gonna say I never went back and okay, no, it's not. That's not where it is. Well, look, I think I can backtrack through this stage, can't I? Ugh, jeez. Okay, let's backtrack. No, let's go. I can. There's nothing wrong with that. Dishwasher? Yes. What do we got? A star? What the hell am I gonna do with a star? Oh, here we go. There we go, that was easy. Okay, I'm definitely glad they put that star there because freaking spikes in this game. I always used to call them clubbers because I wasn't. Dude, you gotta get in there. Thank you. Because I wasn't familiar with spikes, because I had never beaten Mario Bros. 3, but I played a lot of Paper Mario, so I always called them clubbas, but they're totally spikes. I think I've talked about this before in this LP, which is pretty stupid, but... Oh well. You know, I'm gonna be out saving the world anyway. I don't know why, whenever I record this game, I just can't stop. Like, this game is just so arcadey and fun. Okay. Shrooms in the snow, take two. Now that we have a fire flower, I guarantee I'm gonna find one in the first 3 seconds of the level. Well, I guess the first 2 seconds are up, but maybe I can find one in the next 3 seconds. Switch back to that. I, Can't see where I'm going. I can't see what I'm doing. Okay, now just get you guys out of here. Go on the bottom path. Dwan, dwan, dwan. Here we go. There we go with that A plus commentary again. What sound does a bounty block make in Mario? Dwan, dwan. You got it right. Good job, Jimmy. You got it right. You made the right sound. What the hell am I talking about? I tell you. Okay, anyway. There it is. Not quite that one level of Star Road in Super Mario World. That level is a fucking pain in the ass where you have to spin jump down through all the blocks, but it's really easy to miss the secret because you don't know where it is in advance. You know? Fuck. There it is. That was an easy mushroom medal. I like it. A choo-choo mullet. Okay, die. Die. Yeah. Man, my mustache is itching. Not now, mustache punch. Jeez, my mustache punch. Holy crap, man. Ah, why is there an airship? What? Just a random airship? You can't just cheerfully have a random airship. Why would you put all this stuff in, all these coins and ice blocks? Coins are not that valuable. They're worth 5 points each. They don't even get you extra lives. They just feel good to collect, but they only feel good to collect when they're in big strings, not single coins frozen in blocks. If it had been like 4 coins frozen in each block, then it would have felt really good to like bust open those ice blocks and pick them all up. But okay, now let's do this level over here, Hailstone Shelter. That thing that dude said about the veggies is important here, because you can see, oh, that is a really good teep learning device. At the very beginning of the level, there's a Goomba that walks towards you, but he gets hit by the hail and dies, and not only does it leave you out of danger of getting hit by the Goomba, because the Goomba instantly draws your attention because it's an enemy. It's hostile. It's hostile. It's a problem. It's something to be avoided. So as soon as it appears on screen, you see it. And then, because you're looking at it instantly, okay, there's the mushroom metal. Oh, here we go. Because you're looking at it instantly, you see that it gets killed by the hail, and you realize, okay, the hail is dangerous. What do I have here? And you see, okay, there's sprouts, and then you pull up the thing, and you're like, well, let's just go, and then, maybe you remember what the guy outside in the hub world said. It's a good, I'm rambling, but it's good, it's well designed, you know, that's all there is to say on the matter. Also, really easy to find the, shit. Yeah, really easy to find the shit. I wonder if I would die if I got stuck between these two things. Between, like, the block and the wall. Dude, stop! Would you jump over that thing? I tell you, man. Okay, just look down. They give you that function. Use it. Dude! I gotta get rid of that Shy Guy. I think you can also use Shy Guy. Actually, no, I don't. You know what? I don't think you can. Because if you use a Shy Guy to protect yourself, it only blocks one hail bit. Because the hail kills the Shy Guy, just like it killed the Goomba. Maybe? Is it possible I ignored something earlier in the level? Oh dear. I have to use the hammer here. Just stay in position. Stay on target! Stay on freaking target! Dun 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 dun. Oh, that's the end of the level? That was anticlimactic. I want it! Okay, I don't know what's up there, but I want it! What do we got? A 1-up? Yeah, showing up. There's a lot of 1-ups in this level. There were 3 1-ups. What a cool level. Seriously. Well, I'm officially out of throat lozenges, so if my throat gets any worse, I might just have to stop recording for today. But I don't want to stop recording. I'm having fun here, man. And I can finally, like, relax and just do this without having to fret about college, because I finally got my portfolio in yesterday. Oh my gosh. Okay. I think I see the gimmick of this stage. No, yeah, I really think I do. Let me get out my patented polter bunk kit and sort this shit out. Whoa! I am highly disappointed that those veggies are not pushed around by the wind. Oh, I love this too. If you get you can get blown down into blocks and it breaks the blocks. What are those trees from? I want to say like Yoshi's Island DS maybe. That part right there was like that one part in the cave story waterway. Holy, oh man, I thought I had to fall down there. Okay, which pipe is it? It's this one. Okay, I think I know what I need to do here. I need to get underneath here. And there's the mushroom. Well, that was easy. Holy crap. Is that the only time you actually pull a mushroom metal out of a not a good time for the music to loop. Jeez, man. Holy crap. Okay. Bit of an anticlimactic ending there, but that's fine.
Jeez, it looks like we're gonna get like this whole world in one video.
That didn't even happen with World 1. But I wouldn't mind if we did. Maybe this can just be like World 6, the episode. Nah, we still got two more levels before we even get to the boss. We're up to 16 and a half minutes. I could make like a half hour long video, but I won't. I could go on, but I won't. What was this level called? Oh yeah, because this Parabeetle actually follows you. Whoa! Oh no. This level's really big. Oh, if you jump, it reverses its direction. That makes sense. You must be that Sonic from another dimension. Yes, yes, that makes sense. It doesn't. Dan just, like, cold, like, without an ounce of emotion is like, it doesn't. Okay, what do we got up here? You, my good sir, need to GT the F-O, A-S the A-P. Get up there. This level is basically just like a big maze, so I'm not sure where to even start looking. Oh my gosh, not you guys! These Sparkies bring back horrible memories of Super Luigi Dreams, because the last level in Super Luigi Dreams... In Super Luigi Dreams, these things, Sparkies, or Amps, I think they might actually also be called, are basically used as the game's instant kill obstacles. And the final level of the game starts with you getting a wing cap and having to fly through a whole bunch of them that are all like moving in different directions, and it's freaking impossible. I should LP that game. That would be fun. I've never beaten it in my life. I was never able to beat that final level. Because what you can do in that game also is, like, you can buy items from a shop and, like, take them with you into the levels. So what I would always do is I would go to different levels to grind coins to buy a star. And that would just be how I got past the Sparkies at the beginning, because there was no other way to get past them. It was, like, freaking totally... I just realized, sky bloopers, that's funny. There was, like, no other way to get past them at all. It was freaking ridiculous. If I played that, you would understand 100% like how freaking ridiculous that level was. Would you stop? Would you chill the fuck out, man? Jeez. You know what I just realized? I think the mushroom metal in this level is just like is like that other one where there's just some random like hole in the side of a pipe that you can just walk through for some reason. My computer's lagging. I wonder if I got another message on Discord. Okay, maybe not. This level is gonna be the rest of the video.
Nobody cares! Just play and let it happen!
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no 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 no! Oh god! Oh jeez. This is it. This is where the mushroom metal is. You have to beat this guy to this, because otherwise he grabs the mushroom metal and throws it away. I almost wish I'd shown that, because that's hilarious when he does that. It's like that one shy guy in that level of World 3 who, like, appears holding the coin and, like, immediately runs off a ledge and you have to kick a shell at him to get it to take it from him. Anywho. Next time on... That's going to be it for this episode of Toad Strikes Back. Next time we will take on the Shifting Starship. I don't like the sound of that one bit, but we'll deal with it next time. Why do I always say the words next time multiple times? It's so stupid. Why did I use the word decision so many times?